بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. So inshallah, now we're moving on to al-mufassar wal-muhkam. So we're discussing the kitabullah. And the kitabullah, we have different ways of analyzing, different aspects of analyzing the words. We have taqseem al-awwal, which is what? Khas, am, mushrak, mu'awwal. Taqseem al-thani, bi'atibari isti'malihi, which is what? Haqiqah, majaz, kinayan, sarihan, kinaya. And al-qism al-thalith is when we have the mutaqabilat. We have eight things in here. How clear the words are. We had what? Zahir. And nas. Zahir is the apparent meaning of the text. Nas is the purpose the text has been brought. Now we move on to mufassar. What does mufassar mean? If a word is mufassar, it says, ma zahara al-muradu bihi min al-lafz. Yes, that word, ma min al-lafz. So that word, that whose intended meaning is apparent from the wording itself, from the word. So we know the meaning of the word. However, بِبَيَانٍ مِنْ قِبَلِ الْمُتَكَلِّمِ مِنْ قِبَلِ. But we understand the meaning of the word because of a bayan, an explanation from the mutakallim. Now when the mutakallim has explained what he means, what's his intention, now what happens now? بِحَيْثُ this, the meaning is such, in such a way, لَا يَبْقَى مَأْحْتِمَالِهِ التَّأْوِيلُ وَالتَّخْصِيصِ احتمال تأويلي والتخصيصِ لَا يَبْقَى مَعَهُ معه التهمال لا يبقى معه التهمال التأويل والتخصيص. Now with this, you no longer have the chance to do تأويل التخصيص. Why? Because the متكلم has told you what it means. If I said for you, get me something. Now something is what? Do I mean something? If I told you, I said something, i.e., a glass of water. Now I've done. You know the meaning of something because of بيان من قبل المتكلم. The متكلم himself explained what he has meant. Now you can't say, oh well, I think he meant this. He's already said what he meant. You understand? There's no ihtimal of ta'wil or takhsis. Are you following? So ta'wil would mean what? Well, ta'wil would mean that, okay, well, I think it means this. And takhsis is, if the mutakallim has expressed that there's no takhsis, like there's an arm, but the mutakallim has made it clear, every one of you. So it's an arm, and he's done it clear that it's everybody, it's not takhsis. You can't do takhsis. He said, no, it's not takhsis. You following? So everyone must do their homework, every single person, without exception. That's tafsir. That there's no تخصيص not مخصوص منه البعض. Yes? So if the متكلم has explained the meaning of what he has intended or he's explained clearly that there's no what? There is no تخصيص in this. Then it becomes مفسر. The مخاطب and the addressees can no longer do this. For example, we have here فسجد الملائكة كلهم أجمعون. Okay? Now, when you say فسجد الملائكة, now, ملائكة is what? Singular or plural? It's جمع. So what can it? Is it عام or is it خاص? It's am. Now, is it am khusanhu al-ba'ad or lam yakhusanhu al-ba'ad? Well, it could be khusanhu al-ba'ad, isn't it? Like, there's no dalil for it, but we could say, well, on the onset, we say, well, all the malaika prostrated, but maybe, if you have other context, maybe the malaika that were there, maybe Allah is going to protect the group, maybe the malaika is not istighraq, maybe malaika is to do with what? A few of them, ma'hud. But we say, kulluhum ajma'oon. What does this do now? This remove the ihtimal takhsis. You say, well, if anybody says, well, like, now, let's say for argument's sake, this was not part of the Quran. For argument's sake, this was not part of the Quran. Then we can say, well, there's a hadith, or there's a qiyas, or there's some kind of other thing that said that all the angels are prostrated, only some prostrated. Then only some prostrated. We say, okay, this is a possibility. But obviously, the hadith is a contrary to the Quran. But you say, well, there's no dali that can say, oh, some angels are prostrated. Because why? Kullu majma'un. The ihtimal of takhsis is gone. Because the mufassar is very clear that this is am ghayr makhsus. Are you following? Yes? So this has no ihtimal of takhsis. Yes? Are you following? Do you understand? Everybody following me? Online? Yes? What's the hukam now? Wujubul amali bimadlulihi. So now the word malaika is mufassar. What's the tafsir? This is tafsir. This has clarified that is no ihtimal of what? Of what? Of takhsis. So now the madlul of malaika, you do amal on the madlul of malaika. What's the amal here? Is it amal? You have to do something and believe in something. This is belief. So now it's wajib to believe that all the malaika prostrated. Qat'an. Yes? Qat'an. Are you following? However, now what he's saying here is that if it's a khabar, remember, let me go to things. When you have the nusus, when you have a nas, from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is either going to be a khabar or a hukam. You following? Now a khabar is غير, it doesn't have, it can't have نسخة فيه. Because obviously if I say, oh, I came on time. Oh, منسوخ. What's that become? That's a lie, innit? You can't نسخة الخبر. I mean, the khabar is wrong, and that's a lie. But if you have a hukam, you must come out 10 minutes before class every day. And after 1 month, it's منسوخ, come 5 minutes before class. Because everybody's coming on time anyways now, so I don't need to be. Or every day write one lesson, one paragraph in Arabic. Or every day write a chart summarizing the lesson. And I say, okay, منسوخ, no, don't do it anymore. That's fine. So you can do نسخة الخبر, you can't نسخة الخبر. So obviously this can become منسوخ, can it? So the malaika kullum ajmal. But if, for example, we had a ruling, which is a hukam, then that hukam can say, well, it's mufassar, it's not makhsus, we know it's not makhsus. But during time of the wahi, it can become منسوخ. Let's say, for example, for argument's sake, let's say, for example, what could we have an example? Let's say, for example, we have an which is mufassar, it's not makhsus. Let's say, for example, Prophet said, this example, okay, let's say, for example, our hypothetical Prophet said, لا تزورو, it's not hadith, but example, لا تزورو أي قبر, do not visit any grave. لا تزورو أي قبر. So for, say, for example, لا تزورو أي قبر, do not do زيارة of what? Any grave. Now, or let's say, for example, if say here, for example, صوموا كل يوم كل يوم من رجب, for example. Now, كل يوم, now it's not what? It's مفصل, like كل means every. Yes? كل يوم رجب. يصوموا رجب, رجب, صوموا, صوموا رجبا. So now, it's عام, رجب isn't it? عام, because every month, it means not talking about the month, but every part of the day. But it can be مخصوص, can't it? If I say كله, then what's that now? What is that? مفصل. It can't become تخصيص, because كله says, then after that, it says, well, don't fast anymore. So it can منسوخ now. الحكم become منسوخ. That no, before I said to fast Rajab, don't fast Rajab anymore. Hypothetically. Yes? So the كله is a tafsir. That means, it's the tafsir of what? That Rajab is what? عام غير مخصوص. And then when the, but it can become منسوخ. If it's a khabar like this one, it can't become منسوخ. Because then khabar, a khabar can't become منسوخ. Only, ahkam can become منسوخ. Everybody following online? Online, everybody following? Any questions? Yeah, you understand? Okay. The next one is muhkam. So now مفصل المحكم. What does محكم mean? مزداد قوة على المفصل. Which is what? Even more clear than مفصل. Now basically محكم, it has to do with what? نسخ. It can't change anymore. Yes? It says here, لا يقبل التأويل والتخصيص والنسخ أصلا. Yes? Now it's محكم meaning, that's it, that's the verse. You can't, it's not open to any interpretation. It's just clear. Yes? For example, والله بكل شيء عليم. Allah is what? Powerful over everything. Now, كل شيء. Now this is the khabar. So إخبار can't have إخبار أو محكم anyways. So it's محكم in that aspect. And it can also be محكم. We've explained this before in the first understanding أصول الفقه. We say محكم is two types. We say محكم لي ذاته أو محكم لي غيره. Yes? What's muhkam li dhatihi? That muhkam which is what? It can't be what? It can't be mansukh at all. A muhkam li ghayrihi is that which has become muhkam because of what? The mawti rasulillah. Because the Prophet has passed away, we know that's the final ruling. Yes? Because the Prophet has passed away, we know what? That's the final ruling. There's nothing else left. And muhkam li dhati means that the word itself, even the Prophet's lifetime, won't become mansukh. Two things. Why? Number one is, it's a khabar. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحَ إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ. Because it was mansukh. Allah didn't send Nuh to his qawm. Because Allah said it. So it's khabar. It's not going to become mansukh. It's an information. Or, the sigha. The sigha itself is such that it wouldn't allow what? Nasr. For example. What example? You know that? Huh? That's a khabar, isn't it? Abadan. But abadan. لا تقوم على قبري أبدا. So you say أبدا أو لا تقبل مشهرا أبدا. Meaning ever. So the word أبدا says, well, this is, has already told us this is غير منسوخ. I mean, and everything else is, so in theory, hypothetically, if Allah wanted, he could have said, well, Ramzan is منسوخ, no more Ramzan fast. When the Prophet passed away, we know that now, that's the last reason. That's the last ruling. when abadan comes as sighatan, Allah says abadan, so from the onset we know this is what? Forever. This is now a permanent rule. Are you following? So a muhkam is that which has no possibility of nasr. It cannot be abrogated any further. You following? Yes? Njee. Okay? And there's more details and more nuances we can discuss in a bigger book. This is a big, small primer. So you get an understanding of muhkam. It doesn't have ihtimal of ta'wil or takhsis, and it can't become mansukh. Okay. And hukmuhu, luzumul amali. If it's an amal, you do amal upon it. And if it's not to do amal, if not amal, it's for i'tiqad. You do amal on the i'tiqad, la mahala. You must do amal on that. You must have i'tiqad on it, belief. If it's an amali ayah, you do amal on the ayah. If it's an i'tiqadi ayah, you have to have i'tiqad on the ayah. Yes? So, if you have a recap now, we have here now, the kitab, we have al-muqaddimah, was usul al-fiqh, topic of usul al-fiqh, and the purpose of usul al-fiqh. Then we went through the kitab Allah, we said the kitab Allah have four taqseem. In the four taqseem, what are we saying here? There are four aspects we can analyze a Quranic verse. Four different ways. Based on the word usage, we can have khas, am, mushtarak, mu'awwal, we've explained that before. Or we can have what? Haqiqa, majaz, sari, and kinaya. And then in taqseem muthalis, we've done first four, zahir, nas, mufassal, muhkam. Zahir is the word that's apparent from the text. And nas is what? Is the reason the text has been brought. Mufassar is a word that has been clarified from the mutakallim. And he either clarifies one of two things. He either clarifies the meaning, so he can't have any other meaning than what he has said. Or he's clarified, it's not going to be what? Makhsus. And muhkam is that it can no longer become mansukh. Are you following? Ji. Good. And now we're going to go on to these. Remember I told you, these are times two. You have opposites of these. We'll discuss that in the next lesson, inshaAllah. Okay, subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.